CEO, it's been confirmed Phakamani Hadebe has resigned. A statement that's been released by Eskom says, according to the chairman of the Eskom board, Mr. Jabu Mabuza, Phakamani has been an instrumental in driving stability at Eskom. You know, of course, that Eskom has been going through its own challenges, Francis, centered as well at the Commission of Inquiry into state capture, the shenanigans that are taking place there. So for the resignation of the Eskom CEO, Phakamani Hadebe, to come at this time, certainly, I think, a blow for Eskom as it battles with a number of challenges.
So incredible timing, because he's only been in office for about a year, and I guess this will add to the fear that Eskom is in such a mess that it's incredibly hard to fix. So listen to what Mr. Hadebe says. It's no secret that this role comes with unimaginable demands, which have unfortunately had a negative impact on my health. In the best interests of Eskom and my family, I've therefore decided to step down. And this is just weeks after we hit stage four load shedding for the first time. Talks that the Eskom grid is so tight here, and a lot of debate amongst government officials about how this will be handled, whether there can be some unbundling that's been decided, but that's all still up in the air how it's going to actually happen. This is bad news.
This is certainly bad news, and as we head into a deep winter, we need to hear from Eskom how they plan to deal with some of these challenges without it having a CEO. Now, this also falls on the backdrop of just the recent resignation of the spokesperson of Eskom as well. So now we're hearing from the CEO, Phakamani Hadebe, citing health reasons for him stepping down as the CEO of the power utility. And certainly, I think many questions will be asked at this stage, as with such an important institution, without a head at this time, how then Eskom will be able to traverse some of the difficult waters that it is in currently. I think also part of the statement that has also been released here says they thank Mr. Hadebe for his fulfillment of his duties at such a critical mandate, and says it's quite commendable, and he's conducted himself in a way that has managed to try and keep Eskom afloat in the midst of so many challenges.
So the resignation of Phakamani Hadebe, also bad news, I think, for Public Enterprises Minister Pravin Gordhan, who endorsed him as the man to turn Eskom around, as the man to be at the helm, when we know that so many previous CEOs, including Brian Malefe and Machela Koko, have been implicated in serious wrongdoings at Eskom, sort of adding to the woes of electricity users across the country. So he was endorsed, Jabu, the chair, also saying he was the right man for the job. And that was about a year ago. He's stepping down today.
Well, so I also wonder what reaction there'll be. We'll certainly bring you all of that as we continue to track this breaking news story. The reaction as well from unions, who were quite concerned with the announcement, of course, by the president-elect now, Cyril Ramaphosa, a bit earlier, about the unbundling of Eskom, with the unions themselves, raising questions about whether there will be job losses, and, very critical of the now outgoing CEO of Eskom, Phakamani Hadebe. So we'll bring you all of that reaction as we continue to track this breaking news story for you. The Eskom CEO, Phakamani Hadebe, stepping down from the power utility Eskom. That's breaking news at this hour. We'll bring you a lot of reaction to that. Certainly that there'll be a lot of reaction to that from the unions and quite a number of stakeholders within that particular sector. And what does this mean for Eskom and keeping the lights on? I guess South Africans would want to know now, keeping the lights on when you do not have someone to lead this very important institution.
As you said, we head to the middle of winter, load shedding, the bugbear of South Africans. All right, that's your breaking news. We take a short break. We'll be back with sports and much more.